Hello and welcome in. My name is Drumroll Tony. I'm a streamer on Twitch, musician, and music teacher living in Seattle. We are under 4,000 people away from hitting 100,000 subscribers on the channel. Can you help me reach this goal? Please and thank you. Click that subscribe button. I appreciate you so much. Oh man, Chainsaw Man, what can I say? Episode one was wild. I reacted to that in my Patreon. Can't wait to do the next one. That was a lot of fun. Pochita is like way cuter than I thought a chainsaw dog would be. Also, dude had more songs in him than I thought. So that was a pleasant surprise. All the music in this anime so far has been great to listen to. We're about to hit ending four. This is the full version. The song is Tablet by, how do I say the band's name? Is it Tubo? Is it to oboe? Is it to buey? You're going to have to let me know in the comments below, please, and thank you. I appreciate that. Oh, and also, if this is your first time here, my reaction style is more of a surface-level musical analysis. What does that mean? That means we listen to the music in chunks, sometimes stopping in phrases, middle of phrases, end of phrases. We rewind a lot and talk about the layers, and then probably rewind again. So, letting you know. Okay, I'm excited. Let's go. Wait, was there a chainsaw rip there? I was like laughing because of the screen. Hold on, is there a chainsaw rip? Oh yeah, there is. Wait, this sounds like the opening. Remember that sweet bass part? This is similar in construction, like. It's slower and like a longer feel, but like you could say it's like its distant cousin for sure. I'm just gonna go back. Sorry, I was only listening to the bass part going, wait a second. They're different bands. Oh, that's wild. All right. Is that a 12-bar phrase? That was cool. Anyway, it didn't feel as symmetrical as it could have. Or the little B-side to the first verse was... No, it wasn't asymmetrical. Anyway, whatever. It felt cool. Yeah, this almost has like a funky... Like that keyboard part. It's like Stevie Wonder-ish with how like... It's going on. And to match that, I really... On the guitar layer, I really feel like there's kind of like a ska thing going on. We have a lot of upbeat... things with like some fun chord resolutions going on. It's kind of like, you know, well, considering the Chainsaw Man, it's not party-ish. This music feels like, you know, it's up for sure. I'm gonna go back 15 just to grab that. Just try to listen to the guitar layer and how it's working with the keyboard there, because that's pretty it's cool. Okay, so we gotta talk about the drum part, right? Like, I don't know much about this band or the artist, but it's so like perfect. It's not a real person, is it? It feels like it's created. I don't know. I don't know anything about this group, but obviously we've had some real bands in the previous ending. Sorry, not that it matters. I'm just listening to how live the other parts sound and just kind of like going, okay, that's interesting. That is an interesting comparison. So back five, let's keep going here. The vocals sound nice. I just, one thing that is funny is how bright that hi-hat or probably a tambourine sound. It is the highest level above everything. I'm not complaining. You know, as percussionist, I'm like, yeah, man, there you go. Get your two notes up there. It's just interesting that it cuts that much through the vocal line. All right, here we go. Okay, so remember in the last one during the break core, and I was like, whoa, that sounds like samba. This part really does. Well, I mean, an American samba, not a Brazilian samba, but this was like, it was too square to be, but it's basically a dotted 8 to a 16th rhythm, which is obviously common anywhere. But let's listen again. Yeah. Okay, that was fun. Bat digga that gaga. Yeah, man. Check, but slow. I swear these people keep dipping into South American rhythms here. This is cool and just putting the spin on it. I mean, not that it matters. The world is the world. We share everything. We're all, there's a lot of opinions on music and where it comes from. And, you know, we won't get into that. But point being, I love it. It's very cool. Let's go back 15, 5, 10, 15, and we'll let it go into this. Probably the bridge here. Oh, phone guitar line, don't need the vocals. Wow, did you hear the carnival carousel? Sweet keyboard line that's going on underneath there. Obviously, we're dropping in here. And I know most people probably just listen to the vocals, you know, because that's the predominant part. So I feel like that's like obligatory. Yeah, it's cool. It's great. But listen underneath that. It's a lot cooler, in my opinion. Listen to this keyboard part coming up. And of course, we end with the scream. That makes complete sense, right? That was really cool. There was like this cool underneath response melody to the vocals. So we're going to go back 15 and grab that again because there's too many things to listen to. This one, it feels a little more accessible though. Like there's stuff going on, but it's not like 25 things. The harmony is nice. That's the best part of the song right there. That deviation, that's probably the actual bridge. That was cool. That like little fidelity switch that kicks you in the ears. The best part was that big descending chord sequence there, and the voicing just got really, really cool. That was actually really nice. I'm gonna go back 5, 10, 20. I think that's enough to get this, maybe. It is not. Let's add another 10 to that. That was really nice. Just if you didn't catch it the first time, because obviously you get kicked in the ear by that like digital scrape sound, just check out that keyboard. Oh yeah, I went too far. For real. Oh yeah, man. That is good. Sorry, it doesn't descend the whole time. There, it is still a progression there with some intervallic leafing, but just the voice leading on it is really good. And I heard guitar in that the second time, big open, kind of lightly distorted, fuzzy chords. There's a lot of cool little just digital runs that are, I don't know what to call those, like just like little computer type sounds that mix in there that really like fill in the gaps. If you took those away, this would still be cool. But for me, that really like makes it the orchestration, the design of how the sounds are layered out on the page sound really good and sound really full. Go back 5. Let's keep going here. Interesting. So we had those, like, I call it the carousel sounds because it has that, like, that merry-go-round. But Obviously, it's much faster and a little more psycho, but it's there. But we had a little altered version. There was a little more spice. They put some jalapenos in there. That was real good. I'm going back 15 and grab that part again because that's really fun. But obviously, the other stuff we were mirroring from the beginning, so that should have been very recognizable to you. Okay, well, that was there's like 8-bit sounds there, like there's like some throwback video games. That's fun. It's related, but like not related. This section just kind of came out of nowhere for me. I'm gonna go back 15 just to grab it again. Okay, that's interesting. Maybe the 8-bit low-end percussive bass stuff has been there the whole time, but there's just been so much stuff on top of it, we didn't really have a chance to hear it. Because that'll happen a lot, right? When you mix a lot of sounds in, you just... volumes, dynamics, everything just kind of cloud stuff up. So it's possible that's been there, I just didn't hear it. But we heard it now, though, for sure. That's pretty cool. This one is jumping around. Not jumping around in the sense like the other ones did with like just complete chaotic switches. But like musically within a theme and progression, we do have some jumps, so it's still pretty cool. Yeah, the ending was sick. That was really good. That was great writing. I was just thinking in my head, I was like, how do I rank? Hold on, let's save this. I need that ending again. That was really fun, actually. I did not expect that at all. That was probably, for this one, it's saving grace for me. That was really that is so cool because we're still moving along. The same tempo is there. We didn't modulate because we didn't stay there. We call that a metric modulation. If that became the new perceived, like whatever rhythm we would say that would be, but we didn't. We were still there, but it's still very clever. I don't know. The video I'm listening to has a lot more on the end here, but it might be one of those videos where they attach like ending music. You know, that is. I'm just going to hit play really quick. I'm pretty sure this is the end. Yeah, that's got it. Right? It's got to be. Yeah, okay. There's the cheese ball music. Okay. The ending made this piece pretty cool. For me, and I want to know your list too. Where are you thinking on this? For me, as far as like my order of preference, it's ending 1, ending 3, ending 2, and then ending 4. That's my list so far. As far as like musically what's going on, but this was cool. I just was like, man, it's just... yeah, it's a lot of the same, but then we got to the end, and that bridge also was really funky too, so I really enjoyed that, because for me, a lot of variety is like important, just to keep my brain going, but who cares about me? I want to know what you think. Let me know in those comments, please, and thank you. My name is Drumroll Tony. Make sure to catch me on live, so we can talk about Chainsaw Man or just anime music in general. You can find the link to my Twitch channel in the video description below, as well as my Discord. Do you want to support the channel? You can do that now. I have a Patreon. You can request what goes on the channel, actually. You can have guaranteed monthly requests. You can check out the vlog. You can watch anime episode reactions with me. It's a good time. The link to that is down below. Please and thank you so much for the support. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you. Take it easy. Bye-bye.